important. Now, the first thing that these females will say to me is, are you mistress? That's the woman asking my name. The woman even asked me my birth name, don't ask me the race of me.
If young men and young women have no hope, the community is so disorganized. We're talking about religious institutions are doing brilliant work but doing it in silos. We're talking about the educational system that's constantly failing our young people, and predominantly young people that come from specific communities are being failed by the educational system. We're talking about families and the wider community not understanding the reality of young people and the issues in which they're faced with on a day-to-day basis. We're talking about this idea that young people that have what I call perceived fear within their communities, that they can't navigate their way through a community or an environment, and they genuinely believe that they need to have weapons or they need to arm themselves or join gangs in order to keep themselves safe. And then we're also talking about individuals within our community that understand some of these issues and oftentimes unwilling to support and help young people around those problems. And then we talk about issues around the police, and we talk about, you know, broken relationships within the police and the relationships between policing and community. You know, we're talking about a long history of racism, institutionalized racism, and all of these things that I've mentioned, plus many more when we're talking about poverty and the impact of austerity and of lack of resources in those specific communities. You have young people that are making decisions, and those decisions are based on options that are limited to them. So many young people take what I call the easy cut, and they feel that they need to jump to themselves. Yeah. Okay. Because they witness and they see a system that is failing them and a society that don't seek to understand them, meeting their needs.
Tragic. Mm-hmm. It was 1994, and I was sentencing a woman who was 57 years old.
Okay.
She had multiple felony drug and theft cases. I became aware of the fact that I had some more of her family in my courtroom. She was 57. She was born in 1937.
Mm-hmm.
I had her 43-year-old daughter in my courtroom. The 43-year-old daughter was born when the 57-year-old was 14.
Wow.
Okay? The 43-year-old daughter had a 34-year-old daughter in my courtroom. The 34-year-old daughter was born 1 week prior to the 43-year-old's 10th birthday. Now, the thought of a pregnant 9-year-old is just sickening.
Mm-hmm.
But the 43-year-old also had a 32-year-old son born when she was 11 years old. And a 31-year-old daughter in my courtroom born when she was 12. The 34-year-old daughter of the 43-year-old daughter of the 57-year-old daughter had a 21-year-old daughter born when she was 12. And when I sent the 21-year-old daughter, she had an 11-year-old daughter who was pregnant with her second child.
God, you can't make this up. Oh, God.